Hello everyone, welcome to CodeVio. This is our sixth part of our flutter injection series. So in this part we will be doing the storing of our to-do in the local storage of our mobile. So we have the every functionality of a to-do list application have, because we can add a new to-do, we can edit our existing to-do, and also we can delete our to-do. But if we restart our application or if we close our application, we will lose our information. That is because we are not storing it in a local storage. So we are doing it using a Flutter package which is named as shared preferences. You can see here, this is the package we will be using. Okay, so by using this package we can store data in the local storage of our device, so we can persist our data. So I'm just going to include it in the pubsec to yam file. If we need any extra packages from the outside, we need to mention that as a dependency in this file, so the Flutter can download this code related to these packages, and which will be available for our application to use. That's the command flutter pubget, which does all the operation I have mentioned just above. Okay, so we need to tell that the Flutter that I have to need these packages for using, so you please download it and make it available. That's where we are staying in the dependencies. Okay, so this is how we can install a new package to our application. Okay, so if we included any new package, please stop the running application and try to rerun, because the new downloaded code will not be pushed to our application. So for that we are rerunning our application. Okay, now we need to implement our storage functionality. Okay, so you can see that we are storing up to now we are storing it in a list to do, but we need to replace it with the one we will be retrieved from our local storage. So we will store these details in the local storage, and when the app opens we will retrieve it from our local storage. Okay, that's the procedure we are going to do in this video, so we can go. So I'm going to instantiate the package that I just included, that is the instance of the shared preference packages. So I'm just calling the shared preferences preference equal, because I am giving a name. Okay, so I declared a variable which is a type of type shared preference. Then I am writing a function called setup to do. This function is used to retrieve the data that has been stored in the local storage when we are running application and when we start our application. Okay, so firstly I am instantiating the shared preference variable. So preference.avid shared preference.getInstance function will be called. So we will get an instance of this class. So our preference variable is now a shared preference instance. Okay, now we can do further. Now we will get we will store the data inside the shared preference as in string format. So we are retrieving the data stored as in string format. To get the data stored in as in string format, we use the method getString, and we need to mention a key. So we will be storing our data as in a to-do key. So I have given the key as to-do. Okay, so we have the string to-do contains the string form of our data. So we need to convert the string form of data to our to-do object and then to the list of to-dos. Okay, that's our procedure. So we have the to-do object in string format, so in we need to convert it into to-do object and then to to-do list. So we are going to do it. So firstly I am going to convert the string formed data into the list format. For that I use the JSON decode method, and I'm just giving the string to do inside the JSON decode. Okay, so after this line I will get a list of to do, which inside which I have the to do object, but not in the actual to do object form, but it is in the string format. So once again I need to iterate to every item in the list and convert it into our to-do object. That's the procedure, okay? I'm going to do. Okay, we have a list here and the list contains to-do object in string format. So I need to convert the string format into a to-do object. So I'm going to iterate to every item in the list. So let's see, you can see what to do in to-do list. So the to-do what to do in to-do list gives the each item, and I'm going into set state, and inside the set state method I am going to add each to do into our original to do's list. Okay, to do dot add, and inside that we have declared a to do dot from JSON method in the to do class. I have told that you will know the implementation afterwards. Yeah, this is the implementation for that method. Okay, so we will get the to do object from the to do string. Okay, for that only we declare that from JSON method. You can see here that we will be passing a JSON data, which is our to do in the string form, and we will return a to do object back. So we will get a to do object from our string. It's a very easy approach. That's why we have declared that message. So the every data which has been stored in our application has been got from our local storage. Now we need to store data also, because when we add new to do or when we update our to do or when we delete our to do, the to do list will change. So we need to reflect that change to our local storage also. So for that I am implementing a method called save to do. In the save to do, okay, now we have the list, that is to do's list. The to do's list contains to do objects. So first I am going to convert our to do list into a JSON string format. So you know that shared preference will store data in string format. So I want to convert every item to a JSON format. So firstly I am going to iterate to our to do's list and convert each item into a string, okay, in a string format. So we have already declared a to JSON method in our to do class, which will convert our to do object into a string format and return. So in this to list items contains to do object in its string format, and the method to JSON has been declared in the to do class. Let me show. You can see that to JSON method. This method will convert the to do object to a string format, and the string format is also called a JSON format, and the JSON will be returned there, and we are included it into a list, and we need to convert the whole list into another string format. For that we again use a JSON encode method. So we require two conversion. Firstly we are converting our to do object into a string format. After that we are converting our list into string format. Whole thing is done with the help of JSON. Okay, so I am going to set the preference.setString method is to set the string. So you know our key is to do. I have given the key, and after I give the list in JSON format to our set string method. So the items is passed as a parameter to JSON.encode method. So you can see that I am setting the to do string to do as string in our local storage. This how we can store and retrieve to do's. We use with the help of the JSON type to store and retrieve data from our local storage. Okay, now we have the two method, which will either one is used to set up to do and also one is used to save to do. Okay, so we need to call these methods. Firstly I am calling the setup to do when the app first runs. So the init state method, you know about it, init state. The init state method, inside init state method I am giving the setup to do. So it will be called once when the app runs firstly, and we need to use the save to do also. So we need to use the save to do in two cases. Firstly when we click on the to do view page, and after it that it returns. Okay, if the any modification has been done, the to do object will change. So we need to set up to do after we called our to do view page. So you can see that this is the line where we pass our control to do view page. So after this statement I can give the save to do method. So if any modification has been done from that page and return to this page, that will be affected into our local storage. And also if we delete any to do, Okay, then we need to reflect that in our local storage. So for that also we are going to give the say to do method. We are calling the say to do method after the delete operation has been done, which is the line we have implemented the delete operation. Okay, that's then I think once more we need to also to one place, that is we are also having an add functionality. So if the new today has been added, it must also be reflected to our list. So for that I'm also calling the say to do in the add to do method. So after the every operation has been done, our to do will be added. So just add an to do. Okay, let me give any title and also a git description, and let me save. So you can see our new to do. Let me restart and check whether any problems arise or whether our app car works correctly or not. Let me check. So okay, there's some problem exists. Let me look. Okay. We have forgotten to clear our to do. That's the problem. We have already hard coded the to do and we have forgotten to clear it. So let me clear the to do. Okay. We need to implement an empty to do list, and after that we will add items dynamically. So I just forgot to remove it. Okay. Just remove it and we can continue. Let me test. So okay, the to do will be clear right now, and we need to add our new to do. Let me add a new to do. Okay, let me give the title and let me give a description. Okay, let's save and go for it. Yeah, okay, the new to do, first to do has been added. Now we can try restarting our app, whether the to do goes or not, it persists or it works perfectly or not. Let me check. So the app has been restarted. You can see that the to do has not been lost. Yes, hoo-ha, we have done it. The data still persists. So we have done it. Now we can test once more. This is the second to do. Then any description. Okay, let me save. Okay, the second also appears the no problem. Let me mark it as done. Yeah, that also appears. Well, everything is working perfectly. Now if we close our app also, then this code will persist. Let me show it. I will just close the app and let me open it. Yeah, it's versus the it will not lost when we close our app because we have stored it in our local storage. Okay, you can see that I have restarted the app once more. The data is there still because we have retrieved the data from our permanent storage. Okay, that's all. I think that's much all is needed. So this is the end of our series. So we have built a to-do list application. I have skipped some of the code typing because to reduce the length of the video. So okay, I think you don't feel any problem. Okay, and also I have given the link to this GitHub repository where I have posted the code. You can, if you feel any doubt, you can go and check it out there. Okay, and if you like the video, please hit the thumb icon. And if you have any queries, please put in the comment box, and also please share my video, subscribe to my channel. You'll get more content like this. Okay, then bye.